Crossroads. Each Crossroads story is based on the actual experiences of American clergymen, pastor, priest, or rabbi, the men who give inspiration and guidance to people at the crossroads of life. These dramatic stories are presented with the cooperation of our board of advisors, Captain Maurice M. Witherspoon, Father George B. Ford, and Dr. William F. Rosenblum. In your travels, have you ever stopped off here where you can name your action for money, marbles, or matrimony, and be fated either way? Father Edmund Boyle came here for a new and different kind of action.
Dream this up.
Father Boyle, he thinks it's a necessary work.
Well, I won't argue that, but does he have to set up his shop on the main street, practically next door to my club?
Oh, do you own the Lodestar?
I'm Paul Martin.
I'm Father Edmund Boyle.
Father?
Yeah, I'm the idiot.
Oh, I'm sorry, Father. But sometimes a man lets his tongue get ahead of his brain.
Say, tell me something. Are you, opening up for the day or closing up for the night?
We never close, Father. It's a 24-hour operation. People come here to gamble, and time and money they keep no track of.
Until they run out of one or the other.
Or both. Father, are you going to be trouble?
Oh, no. No, my work is to try to keep people out of trouble, not to make it.
Max, one more little one on the house. Big-hearted Martin, known for his hospitality throughout the West.
Ain't the hard way and the number is 10. Bets are coming, don't forget the field. He's coming out. A11, pay the come and the field, and the number is 10.
You won. I must have brought you luck. How about betting a little chip for me, honey? Well, it's me, remember?
You got all you're gonna get.
I'll settle for a highball.
Get lost.
Oh, come on, honey. Just one little chip. Why, you big ape. I'll get you.
Howie.
Hey, boy, you can't do this. He's the one. Oh, yeah. You get your hands off me.
Alex, sister, you get out of here and stay out. You're no better than the work Lodestar customers.
It's a public club. You can't treat me like this. I'm going back in.
No, you're not going back in.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, Sheriff, you know what the charges are.
Come on, Susan. We got the pink room all fixed up for you.
No, no, please don't take me. No.
What's the matter? What'd she do?
Mooching drinks, stealing chips, among other things. Why?
She's pretty young, isn't she?
In years, yeah.
What do you mean by the pink room?
Why don't you ask him?
I intend to.
In other words, this so-called pink room of yours is nothing more than a drunk tank where these girls are left to rot. Is that it?
Oh, calm yourself now, Father. We're doing them girls a favor. They got no friends, no relatives. They're broke.
Sure, sure. So jail is a favor, huh?
Well, at least here they get food and shelter. If I was to turn them loose, they'd just go out and start drinking again. And, well, you know.
Not anymore.
No?
No, I'm changing things.
Oh, you're changing things.
Yes, I am. I think these girls need a chance. And I'm going to give it to them. A real chance to get on their feet.
Well, I wish you a lot of luck, Father, but I think you're wasting your time. You can't rehabilitate these girls. They're young, yes, but they spent too many years to get themselves into the gutter.
Sheriff, after you pick these girls up, I'll give you 5 minutes to call me, and I'll sign them out on my own responsibility.
You're taking on a big headache.
It's my head. Remember, 5 minutes from the time of their arrest.
For the girl, Father Boyle would see to it that she had a few weeks' rest at the nearby convent and the choice of a ticket home or a legitimate job. Father Boyle's work had begun. 16 hours a day, 7 days a week, they watched Father Boyle offer the hand of hope and help to the weak, the sick, the lost. People out of luck and broke found their way home. Into the long night hours, the light burned in Father Boyle's tiny office.
Well, I see you have to keep in shape, even in your ragged.
Helps. You work out here, too?
No, Father, being up here is just a stall. I wanted to talk to you.
What about?
My name is Adams. They call me Truck. I guess you can see why.
I wouldn't take much guessing. My name's Father Boyle.
Yeah, I know. I heard you're the kind of a guy a man can trust.
Sit down, Joey.
Thanks. I guess being a priest is pretty nice. I mean, knowing you're in good standing with the big guy. The big guy.
What is it you want, Drek?
Father, I got enough on my conscience to make the devil sick. I can't take it no more. I've been living bad all my life, Father, and now I got a feeling that my time is up.
Oh, you're not that old.
Well, it ain't just dying. I ain't never been as scared of dying. It's... Maybe you can help me. Maybe you can do something to... Oh, I guess it's too late.
Truck, God has his own way of forgiving. If you're really, truly sorry for your sins.
I ain't been to Mass in 29 years. And all those years I've been building up every sin there is in the book.
Well, that's a lot of building.
I know. And I done it all. You know what my trade is?
No.
I'm what they call an enforcer, a trigger man. Started out working for a bootlegger. It was prohibition, and I was a smart kid. Can you help me, Father?
God has his own way of lifting the burdens from our hearts. Well, look, tomorrow's Easter Sunday. What do you say you come over to the chapel, go to confession and communion?
Thanks, Father.
Good morning, Father.
Good morning, Susan.
Good morning, Father.
Hiya, Chuck.
Morning, Father.
Morning, Sheriff.
With Truck Adams in church, the good Lord had better be wearing a bulletproof vest. Oh, I didn't mean anything sacrilegious. It's just that I couldn't quite understand a fellow like Truck, a killer, being here.
Well, killers or sheriffs, makes no difference. The good Lord always welcomes those who want to repent or worship.
That's right, Father. And today, Truck is all yours. But sooner or later, he's going to be all mine.
Oh, it's nothing, Mother Superior. My eyes are just a little tired. I guess I'll have to forget my pride and get fitted to glasses.
Father Boyle looked forward to many years of service and many sinners to be helped back to God. But terrible tragedy was soon to strike this great priest.
Well, I start to work at 7 in the morning, Father. Thanks to you.
You made the change, Susan.
You made it possible. Now it's a whole new world I'm living in. Bye, Father.
Goodbye.
Hello, Trot.
Huh? Hi.
Keep in touch with me, Susan.
I will. Bye.
Say, that was, No, it can't be.
Oh, yes, can be, and it is.
Well, she looks so different.
She is different.
Yeah, I guess I was wrong about her. You know, Father, I was one of the guys that pushed her around. That is, I know this won't change what I've done, but it'll help pay your expenses.
Thanks, Chuck. Excuse me, Chuck, I've got an appointment.
That's all right, Father. I'll look after the place for you.
Thanks.
Well, Doctor, what's the bad news?
It's very bad news, Father. You have cataracts growing on both eyes.
Cataracts? You mean the doctor?
Yes, it's only a matter of time.
He's a good man, Father Boyle. And he's doing a good work.
Much as I hate to agree with a cop, this time you're right. He's the greatest guy in the world.
And you think you can hide behind him? Well, it ain't gonna work, Adams. I told you we don't like killers.
Well, I'm clean now, Sheriff. I don't even pack a rod anymore.
Yeah, I know. I saw you in church, but I ain't buying that. Now, I asked you in a nice way to leave town, but no, you're set on staying. So I'm warning you. I'm gonna get you, and I'm gonna get you good.
Well, you ain't got nothing on me, Sheriff. It's all over and done with.
Father?
Well, Sheriff? What's on your mind?
That friend of yours, Truck Adams. I want to see that gunner Fry.
So?
You can save us some time. I figure he's done a lot of talking to
you. Sheriff, a man's confidences with his priest are sacred. You ought to know that.
Look, Father, I've helped you in your work, and you're going to continue to need my cooperation.
And you're gonna give it to me. You know, Sheriff, that's the nice thing about dealings between honorable men. They have to respect each other's ethics, even if it hurts.
All right, he's coming out. Give me something on cramps and 11. Roll him. 9, he rolled 9, and the point is 5. And he's coming out again. 5, the winner. Pay the line, take the outside. All right, you're not betting, folks. And the number is 10. All right, get your bets down. Give me something on the hot 10.
That's nice. Cash me in, Howie.
Okay, Truck.
You stupid little goon. What are you doing out in the open? You're red hot.
My Truck, is that a way to welcome your pal, Shuck?
Go on back to the big city where you got some protection. Well, the sheriff out here gives you a real welcome.
Now, since when am I going to worry about a hick sheriff? I come up on business.
I'm out of business.
$10,000. It's an easy contract.
So get it, Shep.
Sure, sure. Well, look, I need you, pal. It could be just like old times, just you and me.
Now, listen, you little crumb. I'm through. Through with contracts and through with garbage like you.
Hello, Shepard.
Wrong number. My name is Davis. Sorry.
We wouldn't want to make a lot of unnecessary noise now, would we? Might disturb them customers inside. You wouldn't like that, would you? Come on, let's take a little walk.
I tell you for the last time, I haven't done anything.
Look, I've got dodgers on you from three different states. They're all just dying to hang you for murder. It's going to be a little feather in my cap, too. I knew if I kept a watch in that truck, Adams...
Truck? Oh, that's the reason why you made me so quick. Now I know. I'm going to take good care of that creep.
You're not going to take care of anybody. Maybe we could handle it for you, that is. If you got some evidence.
Evidence? I know that mug for 10 years. I have enough evidence.
Go on.
Only I don't happen to be a songbird. Maybe we can make a deal.
No deal. I guess we'll just have to let him go and settle for you.
Wait a minute. Garbage, he called me. He called me garbage. Go on, get one of your stenographers. I'm going to tell you about some garbage like you never heard.
Miller, bring your book. Sit down, Chip.
Factor? No, Holton. How about an aberration?
Not in your case, Father. You'll retain your vision for a while, but as the corneal scarring spreads, your sight will gradually grow dimmer and dimmer until...
Until there's no sight at all, huh?
Now, these drops will help you some.
Oh, thanks. Doctor, I wish you wouldn't say anything about this to anybody. I'd like to continue my work as long as I can.
Another miss. Matter, Father, you practicing fumbles?
No, Truck. My eyes are a little tired. A little stuffy in here. Here, I'll take a shower.
Okay. Hey, Father. See you tomorrow.
All right.
I doubt it, Truck. You're gonna be tied up.
Well, Father. Carry the ball, will you?
And with every day that passed, the father knew his sight was blurring a little more. He knew it wouldn't be long. Death row. Here are men who have lost their right to live. In this row of cells, living is measured in days and hours. In spite of his busy days, the father was a frequent visitor to Truck's cell.
There you are, Father.
Thanks.
Hi, Chuck.
Hi, Father.
Hi.
Hi. Well, I ain't looking forward to it, but I'm okay. Question is, how are you?
What do you mean, how am I?
I mean, what's the matter with your eyes?
Well, what gave you the idea anything was wrong with my eyes?
Read something. Read that right there.
To everything there is a season, and a time to every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born, and a time to die.
That's fine. That ain't what I was reading.
Well, all right. You read what you were reading. I'll explain as you go along.
Be merciful unto me, O Lord, for I pray unto thee daily.
Rejoice the soul of thy servant, for unto thee, O Lord, do I lift up my soul. In the day of my trouble I will call upon thee, for thou wilt answer me. The Lord is my strength and song, and has become my salvation. Amen.
Fine, truck. I'll be back Wednesday.
Thanks, Father.
Hey, who do you think you're kidding? You're blind as a bat.
What?
You don't fool me for a minute. If it was just glasses you needed, you'd have had them long ago.
Truck, I didn't come here to talk about my troubles.
Well, maybe you need an operation. I got dough, plenty of it.
Money won't do any good. Neither will an operation.
Well, we'll get a specialist.
Dr. Graves is a specialist. Besides, I'd rather not talk about it. Guard! I'll be back Wednesday.
Okay. Kovacs. A message. Dr. Graves. I want to see him right away. He can name his own price, but he's got to come. Graves. He's an eye specialist. You got it?
There must be something you can do. Look, I got plenty of dough stashed away. 10, 20 grand. It's all yours.
I tell you, there's nothing I can do.
You're a specialist, ain't you?
Why are you so concerned?
Because Father Boyle is a friend of mine. He's doing a great work, and I don't want nothing to stop it.
The only thing that would help him would be a new pair of eyes.
Say that again.
Well, to put it simply, an eye for an eye. Replacing his cornea with those from good eyes.
All right, he's got them.
Yours?
Why not? I can't take him with me. Now, you set the whole thing up, but don't let him know about it. He'll put up a beef.
You sure you know what you're doing?
Of course I know what I'm doing. I'll be dead, but part of me will be living and looking at things I never could see for myself. Promise me you'll do it.
I'll be ready.
Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Excuse me, Father. All right, truck.
Well, Father, one of these days I'll be looking around for you.
You're a strange man, truck. God be with you.
Thank you, Father.
Honestly say you are the most beautiful sight I've ever seen.
Father Boyle was back in business, offering his help and hope to anyone with need. People watched him, and their respect became deep affection. During his long days, they saw Father Boyle occasionally pause and spend a moment just drinking in the view. Father Boyle was seeing the world through the eyes of a murderer, and he found it good.